Hi, this is Mozilla, and we would like to share some tips on how to succeed in a game jam. A game jam is a game development competition. It usually spans over a few days, typically 48 or 72 hours, and it has a theme determined by the organization. A jam can be on site where all the programmers and artists meet at some physical location, or remote, where people create the games at their homes or offices. Most jams allow people to participate in teams, although some of them have a solo category. No matter the format or the rules, all jams present a tough challenge. We will now see some tips that can help you to finish your game on time. First of all, embrace all the constraints. Limits are good for creativity. Don't be discouraged because you don't like the theme at first glance. Don't be upset because you are not allowed to reuse assets or code that you already have. The goal of the jam is to have fun and be creative. Constraints can actually help you to shape your ideas. Do a brainstorming session until you find some idea or game mechanic that you really love and want to try out. Before the jam starts, do some preparation so you and your team can hit the ground running. Make sure that everybody has all the software they need already installed and that you all are using the same version. If the jam is on site, don't expect a good internet connection to the last software or install updates. The network will probably be saturated. Besides that, set up a blank or Hello World project. Build it and deploy it in your target platform, be it in the web, or mobile, or an executable file. Make sure that this release can be played in a computer that is not your own. Why do this now? Because you want to sort out potential problems before the jam, and not when the jam is about to end. While you are developing the game, don't mind if your code is not perfect. Your goal is to finish a game, not to have an excellent code base. If hard coding something is going to allow you to implement a feature, do it. Can you create your level by editing a text file instead of writing a level editor or an importer? Do it! You can always polish things later if you have the time. Keep in mind that nobody's going to care if you don't have a well-designed architecture or if you repeat yourself in code. Even if your project is open source and people can check out your code later, don't worry about it. It is a jam. You have to release a game in a weekend. Nobody, not even you, can expect perfection out of this. What people will care about is if your game is fun, not how it was made. You will find out that time is your biggest constraint. You cannot make a complex game from scratch in a weekend, so try to focus on just one core solid game mechanic and implement it before anything else. So for instance, if you're making a platformer game, develop the jams first. It also helps to separate features into two different lists, must-have and nice-to-have. And be prepared for the fact that you might need to cut off a feature in the must-have list. But if you already have your core mechanic implemented, it will not hurt your game much. During the jam, it is useful to build a release every time you implement a new feature. This serves two purposes. First, you will be able to have people to play your game, so you can get feedback and find some bugs. The other benefit is that as the deadline approaches, you are sure to at least have some version of your game to be delivered, in case something goes terribly wrong at the very end. Jams are tough and hard. Morale will be an issue, so try to get as much encouragement as you can. If you work in a team, rely on your teammates. It also helps to check out what other participants are making. Show off your game to other people. If you're making an HTML5 game, post the URL in social networks during the jam, so your friends and followers can try it out. People will cheer for you, and it really helps. If your game cannot be played on the web, you can always post videos or screenshots. Last, remember to take care of yourself. A lot of people load up on junk food and energy drinks, but this will make your energy levels to fluctuate, and your body will suffer. Beers are also quite popular, but remember that alcohol will reduce your focus. You can always wait until the jam is over to celebrate with your teammates over a pizza and beers. To increase your energy and improve your mood, make sure that you go outside at least once a day. Get some sunlight and physical activity, even if it's just a 20-minute walk. In summary, do the things that you would do in a regular day on your schedule. Eat, drink, and sleep as usual. That's all for now. We hope that these tips can be of help during the jam. Have fun, and until next time.